Dublin Airport is, it's a big campus, it's a big place, and we have a huge volume of passengers, 32 million this year. And understanding how people are interacting with the facility, where they are, and all of the moving parts of our own equipment and facilities is increasingly important as we push more passengers through the facility. So I think GIS is going to be a huge development as we roll it out in terms of better understanding of how our passengers are interacting with our facilities, where there might be issues that need to be addressed, and how we can respond to them very quickly.
Very simplistically, asset management is looking after all of the assets here at Dublin Airport, everything from where passengers arrive in the car parks, right through the terminal buildings, security systems, baggage systems, through the main terminal building, the gates that we have, and then out onto the airfield, which are our more linear assets with the runways, taxiways, and the various stands that are associated with that.
For us, the GIS system has a number of benefits, I suppose. It reduces the workload on us, where previously we would have had reports, had to transcribe them into a reporting document, and then again, when we wanted to create graphs and trends to present to our management, we would have had to reproduce that information again. The benefits of ArcGIS is that it does all that for us, so we have live tracking of all our data. There's a reduced workload from us here, but we're also getting the ability to see the information up front as it happens 24 hours, 7 days a week.
GIS has allowed us a greater in-depth review of our trend analysis on airside safety incidents, occupational safety incidents, fire alarm activations, escalator incidents, and other aviation-related incidents around Cork Airport. So the dashboards are the real, I suppose, positive side to it for us, where we're getting a full review of our incidents.
So the dashboard is a tool that we use for reporting, so we can push this around to all management teams, senior managers, and they can get a snapshot of what's going on in the airport in their department at any one time. Then we can also use this data for layering on top of each other and analysing it to come up with different decision-making tools.
We have a live database at all times that I can check from my computer at the back of the base, or I also have access on my phone or iPad, and I can check any works that are in progress as well as planned for that evening or into the weekend also. So it's a live on the spot, I can do a check of it as well as capture any repairs that I might identify during an inspection.
I'd highly recommend the system in a complex airport environment, where there's a huge amount of data floating around, generally stored in different people's hard drives and different departments that are not joined up in the way they could be. The GIS represents in its own right an opportunity to bring those departments together, to share information and to eliminate repeating work, reinventing the wheel and giving people the most accurate information available to hand.